Get ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Bob Donner, Bette Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, former Miss World Marjorie Wallace, Bill Daly, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Just a minute.
Smart?
Very smart, Maria, very smart.
Right, John
White,
you
overdid it. What the hell is this, St. Patrick's Day?
Thank you. What's that?
Is this St. Patrick's Day or something?
Somewhere, Brett, in some town in America, it's St. Patrick's Day, because these tapes, they go from market to market, and it's March somewhere.
It's Gene Kelly.
Kelly Green, right.
Gene Kelly, yes.
Yeah, thank you very much. How are you?
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Thank you. You know Marcia. Marcia, you know Bill.
I love this man.
I saw her somewhere before.
Right.
In a movie.
Yes,
in an old rewrite.
One of my favorite... I love the Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Yes, we were both on it.
You know Gene?
Yes.
Oh, fine. Do you know Daphne Davis and Monty Hill?
Yeah, we know
I do. I
you do. Good. All right. Daphne, briefly review the events of your life for us.
Oh, I attend USC, majoring in broadcast journalism, and one day... I will be a newscaster.
You will be. You want to be an anchor person?
Yeah.
And
travel
a reporter
everywhere.
And do all that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The first thing you have to do is, when I ask a question, you don't say, yeah. You don't do that, you see.
Okay.
Say, yes. Say that.
Yes.
That's good. See, she's
good,
a quick study there. All right, Daphne, good luck to you, Monty. He looks like James Garner, doesn't he?
Yeah. But he's got a wife 20 years younger than he is, that's why.
Yeah.
It helps.
21 after this opening, it's so slow.
After this long opening. She's as old as you are now, in fact.
Me too. What do you want to say, Monty?
Well,
nothing.
Actually, after our last, yesterday's taping show, I've applied for a divorce because I love your massage.
Oh!
Well. Rona Barrett will be glad to hear about
that. You want to explain to people what you did to him? Maybe
yeah, well, yesterday he said he was feeling nervous, so I just rubbed his back like that a little bit to relax him.
So I left his wife for you.
And then he asked me to marry him.
Walking out.
All right, let's carry on here now. No, I don't mean you and me, Monty. I mean with the game here. We're in the middle of round one, and that means, Monty, it's your turn. Here we go. Ed said, my parents never liked me. Once, they left my baby carriage in front of a blank. What do you say, James Garner?
Train.
Wait a minute.
I'm sorry.
I was just making conversation here while we're waiting. Well, I guess we have to
throw it
out.
Doesn't waste time, does it?
Charles hadn't finished writing yet. Had everybody finished writing?
Yes.
No. Charles hadn't finished writing.
Oh.
You didn't write what he said anyway, did you? You didn't? Did you, Bill?
Yeah.
No, Bill's is it.
Oh, Bill was
writing
finished.
Home.
Question, we let it go since... Got to do another question. All right. That's too bad. Well, just for the heck of it,
well,
his answer,
said truck.
His answer was going to be train. Charles, did you
truck.
Say train?
No, steamroller.
Steamroller?
I said truck, too.
You said truck, and what
I
did you say?
Train. Garbage
here?
Truck.
Mine was the Laurel Canyon turnoff off-ramp.
Laurel Canyon off-ramp and train. Front of the, all right. Well, I guess we have to get another question. Should we use a reserve? You've got one right there. Thank you very much. This is Ira Skutch, who will now get $52 for being on camera.
Oh, hi, Ira.
I'll donate to some fund.
To some fund.
Yes.
The Gene Rayburn Charity.
That's it.
Thank you very much, Ira. All right. Here we go. Another one for you. Ready? The doctor said to Carl, I have good news and bad news. The good news is we found out what you're allergic to. The bad news is you're allergic to blank. Doctor said to Carl, long question, isn't it, Monty? Don't say anything until I ask you. You ready? Oh, he just nodded. Playing it safe. The doctor said to Carl, I have good news and bad news. The good news is we found out what you're allergic to. The bad news is you're allergic to blank.
Wife.
Wife. All right, Bob.
I like your coat.
Thank you. I'm glad you do.
I thought for a minute you won the Masters.
Yes, I look like Jim McKay, don't I?
That's it.
Right.
Sex.
Sex. No thanks. All right.
I still like the coat.
Well, I went for what you call the general as opposed to the specific. I said girls, so if the shoe fits, tough.
Uh-huh. That's not a match.
It'll take you a minute to get it.
All right.
Your wife.
Wife, there it is. One for Marty. Good news and bad news. We found out what you're allergic to. The bad news is you're allergic to...
Ding, 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 ding. Your wife.
Your wife. Keep your hands short, diabetes beer. Bill?
Sex!
All right.
I'm not surprised that was your answer.
Yes, you needed it.
You did,
I'll
but
keep
not
this
here.
Myself, right?
Good answer, Bill.
All right, I like to bring a little culture.
A little culture to the program?
All right, what is this from? Thank you, Green has always been very kind to me.
Betty Davis.
The Jolly Green Giant. No.
Thank you, Green has always been very kind to me.
The corn is green.
No.
How green was my valley?
No. Well, this is a motley crew, if ever I've heard.
All right, now
Shakespeare?
Streetcar named Desire.
Thank you.
Charles?
Oh, you wanted
Charles
an answer.
Charles, Johnny, Charles gets $5. He came up with the right answer.
Yeah.
The quote was from A Streetcar Named Desire. Give him $5,
Johnny. Why don't we all give him $5?
No, Johnny.
Well, no one cared, anything. But I thought it was interesting, and the segue being that you have green on.
$5. Thank you, John.
Sell my blood for
fire. I'm happy to help whatever I can, and on top of culture, I give you the right answer.
Uh-huh. Who said that line in Streetcar?
Blanche Dubois.
Who? Oh, Blanche.
Blanche
did.
Dubois.
Blanche Dubois. Played by?
Well,
Vivian
Lee. Jessica Tandy on Broadway and
right.
Vivian Lee in the movie.
Right.
Very good.
Now, let's see. Score is tied. Monty, you're ahead. Oh, Monty has three. It's not tied. You're ahead, so you go first.
Okay,
eight, all right. Three people play, Bob, Brett, and Bill. A psychiatrist said to Bernice, I don't think your husband was really trying to commit suicide. He only jumped off a blank. Waiting for Brett.
This is an interesting answer, I think.
Sure it is. The psychiatrist said to Bernice, I don't think your husband was really trying to commit suicide. He only jumped off a blank.
Curb.
Curb is good. Good response. Bob?
That's, you know, that is really a marvelous answer.
Curb.
Oh, he's good.
Fire hydrant and everything, yeah. Pathetic award answer?
No, pathetic.
Naval award.
Oh.
Well, it's not a...
That's why she's wearing this outfit, which is adorable.
Navy blue.
It's not a naval answer at all.
Well, let them judge.
For those of you who were raised in small towns, you will all know what it is. Bulkhead.
Bulkhead.
Now, when I give an award, it is not chosen lightly.
That's the cellar door. That's what we call, didn't everybody live in a house where you had a cellar door that slanted down that way and it was called the bulkhead?
I had three of them, Annie Brett. I really did.
You're right. That is a bulkhead
Get
door.
Get Tess Meyerson before it's too late.
All right,
You don't have to worry. I'm leaving anyway.
What do you got there?
This is rough, man. He jumped out of the basement window.
Uh-huh. And then he had to jump up. So you pick up one more. It's now 4-2. And Daphne, you'll need 2 to tie and 3 to win right after this. Here we go. Now, Daphne, 2 to tie, 3 to win. Robbie the robot said, what bad luck I have. On my honeymoon, I blew a blank. Yes. Well, you don't play this round either.
That's right.
Oh, that's right.
Nobody
right.
plays at all. This is just you.
Oh, three of you. Robbie the robot said, what bad luck I have. On my honeymoon, I blew a blank.
A fuse.
Certainly. You being a man of reasonable intelligence and a modicum of humor, you should say fuse.
Should? I owe Daphne one, don't I?
Yes, you do. She's wearing a heart on her...
Be very careful, dear.
She's wearing a heart for you.
A heart for me?
Yes.
I was going to say fuse, see?
But you didn't say fuse?
Well, wait a minute.
You
when I get a good idea, I go with it.
It's just I had a tough time spelling it, that's all.
That's right, you get him. Okay.
Okay, what?
Let's see it.
What? Tell it to the jolly Greek.
All right.
no, of course, my darling, the lady with the heart. You.
All right, 4-4 the score. If you say fuse, she wins the game.
Go!
All right. Oh, no. Take your place on the blue dot there if you would, please. And Monty, you'll be back to play your second game a little bit later. We'll spin you off right now, okay? Here we go with you, my dear. Good luck to you. All right, your friends at USC. Did you bring any with you?
No, that's it.
Anybody from USC here? Two people back there. You just happen to be here and you're from USC. Well, I know you'll be rooting for her. Daphne, we polled a studio audience not too long ago and said write down your best answer to this. Urban blank. We give you $500 for the most popular answer, $250 for the second, and $100 from the third. Whom do you want?
I'll take Brit.
Urban cowboy! I'm Bob.
Urban renewal.
Urban renewal is his.
Hell, another fabulous movie I loved. Urban Decay.
Urban Decay, yeah.
My favorite.
Urban Decay?
That's
Urban
right.
Urban Decay, that's right, uh-huh.
Sidney Poitier?
That's right, Sidney Poitier, Morty Gunty, some of the greatest.
Morty Gunty. All right, now you got Urban Decay, Urban Cowboy, and Urban Renewal. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I'm going to go with Urban Cowboy.
You
Urban
got a wise
All right, that was Brett's answer. Let's see if we got Urban Cowboy up there in any spot. May we see the bottom one, please? Urban Renewal.
Well, there's Uncle Bobby's answer.
That's right.
Only 100.
And the next one says Urban Development.
But the animal.
All right.
Be.
The last one says Urban Cowboy.
Very good.
All right. Now, Daphne, you've got $500, which is yours irrevocably, and that means that the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, you will spin the wheel, and if it gets lucky for you, you'll double it up and play for $10,000.
Oh,
good luck to you. Stand right up there. Grab that peg. Give it a pull, and we'll all root for a double. Good luck to you. You have to swing around. That's right. All right. It's worth $10,000. Ready? Okay. I'll be blank soon. I'll be blank soon. Now, Charles has written his answer down, put it in the slot there. Your job now is to match him. If you do that, you get $10,000.
I'll be back soon.
I'll be back soon. All right. Charles, she says, I'll be back
soon. Sorry, home.
Home. Well, those are the two that crossed my mind. I'll be back soon, and
I'll be home soon. They all had back. It's so hard.
Back
the two
or home.
Of them.
Yeah, it was really a toss-up between the two. But you do have $500, and you are going to play game number two, so let's get Monty Hill back here for game number two. There you go. Welcome back, Monty.
Thank you, Jim.
We'll get going with this game in a moment or so, right after we do a little business with America, okay? All right, here we go. This is round one of game number two, the final game. And Monty, you have a choice of A or B?
I'll stick with A.
All right. A says, Ken said I'm in real pain. That's what I get for trying to play catch with a blank. Ready? Chuck?
Yo, Gene.
Oh, sure.
Ken said I'm in real pain. That's what I get for trying to play catch with a blank.
Bong.
time is up. Sock. I'm bored.
Can't think of anything.
I really can't. I'm sorry.
Okay, let's stop the show and go home. That's it, ladies. I can't think of anything, so we'll see.
Can't think of anything?
He said sock was, but he really couldn't think of anything.
Sock?
See, Monty, if you can't think of anything, we're going to go out of business. What do you say?
Well, you had a lot longer than we did, too, Monty.
Yes, right.
I only said it because I like to draw it. Porcupine.
Porcupine is a wonderful answer. Is that a good answer? What do you say?
I say I want to hear you say what a fabulous answer. I say I want to hear you say what a wonderful answer.
Hold on, now, wait a minute. I'll say it even before I see it. Oh, what a fabulous answer.
Porcupine!
Oh, wonderful answer. A terrific answer.
I have never given this before, but it was so blatant, so obvious, I felt obligated. The stolen answer award.
You said porcupine, right? Right?
Porcupine.
Oh, you said it. You did steal it, didn't you? You did steal it,
no,
didn't you?
No, I didn't steal
yes,
it.
Yes, you stole that answer. I'm just taking your $5 away from you that you won from Johnny.
Thief.
That's right. I got it right here. All right, Marjorie. That's what I get for trying to play catch with a...
Ouch.
Porcupine. That's the response. Not that Bill is going to have it.
Well, just to change, yes, I never have anybody's answers.
Well,
I can't
even
match
here.
My own people. I can't match myself. Gee, I didn't have this answer either. No, that's wrong. I said King Kong.
Yeah.
Oh, so you can always count on him when you have a stinko answer to be more stinko.
Right.
Doo-da-doo-da. Dog. Well, it could bite.
Dog,
Marcia.
Right.
Well, it didn't come to me, Brett.
Sock in his mouth.
All right.
Daphne,
you ready for yours? Here we go. Glenda the Gossip said... Here's a little known fact about Dolly Parton. The reason she teases her hair so high is because she keeps her blank under it. You know who Dolly Parton is. Everybody know who Dolly Parton is.
Charles is drawing and he's not paying attention and putting his hands in the slot.
Daphne, Glenda the Gossip said, here's a little known fact about Dolly Parton. The reason she teases her hair so high is because she keeps her blank under it.
Her bra?
Her bra? She said bra.
I heard her.
Oh. Okay, we'll go to the next one. Now, what'd you say?
Bra, Gene.
Oh, you said bra. Oh. Yes?
Now, I don't know what made me come up with this answer, but you know there was that wonderful line of Fred Allen's? He said, you could put an agent's heart in the navel of a knit and still have room left over.
He said that.
Yes, he did.
Right.
I said agent.
An agent.
I love it.
She keeps her agent.
I think that's as good a
point. But you don't have an agent.
No. You have to be
there. You're
not
in show
agents.
Business. If you were in show business, you wouldn't boo that answer.
You'd hurrah it.
You'd boo agents.
Right.
What makes you think we're in show business?
Well,
what do you call this?
Money.
Keeps her money there. Another good one. Bra and money are both good. All right, Marjorie. Dolly Parton, she teases her hair so high is because she keeps her blank under it. What do you say to that?
Well, I owe Dolly an apology, that's for sure. Spare falsies.
Oh.
Spare falsies.
I said I owe her an apology.
Uh-huh.
We have another Aaron Go Bra here, all right?
Aaron Go Bra. All right.
And she's a very musical gal, you know. She keeps her guitar up there.
Uh-huh. All right, so she has two, and Monty, you have none. That's the end of round one, and now this for you. Oh, time to go.
Oh, is it?
Say
we
goodbye.
Have,
go where,
we have 15 more minutes to kill here, so let's
No. We just have a few seconds to say goodbye. Goodbye. Anything you want to say before we say goodbye?
Would you like to say anything, Robert?
Anything on your mind, Bob? What picture?
Are you serious?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, we're on.
Oh,
yeah.
No, I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, come on. Tell us about your picture.
It's called Under the Rainbow with Chevy Chase.
Under the Rainbow with Chevy Chase.
Carrie Fisher. It'll be in your theaters July the 19th.
What year?
19. Are we going to be on next year?
Yeah.
81.
July 81.
Say goodbye, Gene.
All right, say goodbye, Gene. Gene will be here tomorrow for the match game. I hope you will be, too. Bye.
Some of our contestants will receive elegantly styled watches by Jules Jurgensen, ladies' quartz analog with rectangular case, six diamonds, mesh bracelet, plus a gents' quartz analog day date and carat clad case with matching bracelet from Jules Jurgensen. And beautiful sweepstakes carpeting from Galaxy Carpet Mills features ankle-long nylon with Scotch Guard. Galaxy sweepstakes in 10 contemporary colors. And if you notice your nails lightly, buff them to a brilliant no-polish shine with Nail Buffs, the nail treatment for the whole family, the Nail Buff by Terrace of Springfield, Massachusetts. And from across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic, natural tanning lotions and oils, plus this attractive Hawaiian Tropic inflatable rack. And there's a chore boy for every chore. Plastic puffs, clean casseroles, and no-stick surfaces without scratching. Chore Boy Plastic Puffs. More scour to you. Todman Productions. Program is edited for broadcast.